Welcome to the PowerPanel Enterprise Setting Tutorial. In this video, you will learn how to perform initial setup, which includes setting up, auto discovery, equipment list, rack, floor map, map settings, device group, and power calculation. Through the initial setup, you will be able to add new equipment and racks to the system, and manage your floor map, to show the status and real-time information of all equipment. There are two ways to add new equipment to the system. One is through auto discovery, and the other is through equipment list. The auto discovery allows you to search SNMP devices within the specific IP range, and add them to the system directly. In the main page, go to the setting drop-down menu, and under equipment, select auto discovery. Click Add Discovery Job to enter the configuration page. Name your discovery job. And enter the IP range of the discovery job. Assign the authentication profiles applied to the devices. You can also run the discovery job at a specific time automatically, by clicking on the Add button, to select the day and time that you would like to schedule. Once finished, click Save. To run the auto discovery, select the Create a Discovery Job, and click Run Now. A dialog box will appear, and ask for the confirmation to run the discovery job. Click Confirm to proceed. The auto discovery window will show the progress of the discovery job. And the required time of the discovery job depends on the amount of the IP addresses within the IP range and your network quality. Once completed, click OK to close the auto discovery window. And you will see the new devices discovered by the auto discovery in the unassigned devices section. Select the device in the table and fill in the fields in the info panel. Then click on the Add button to add the device to the system directly. A dialog box will pop up, showing the device is successfully saved in the system. Click OK to close the dialog box, and the auto discovery setting is complete. The equipment list allows you to add new equipment or maintain equipment information. Go to the setting drop-down menu, and under equipment, select Equipment List. Click on the Add button to add new equipment. In the Basic Info section, select the category name, manufacturer, model name from the drop-down list, built in by the system. Name the equipment, and enter its IP address. Select the authentication profile to apply a community name to the equipment. You can scroll down to see the information and images of the equipment. Click Save. Now, you can see the new equipment has been added to your list successfully, and the equipment list setting is complete. The rack page allows you to add a new rack or edit the rack configurations. Go to the Setting drop-down menu, and under Equipment, choose Rack. Click Add to add a new rack. Fill in the information of the rack in the Info panel. And enter the total rack units. Then click Refresh to update the rack space in the Display panel. Set the Multi-Columns field to split each use space of the rack if needed. After finishing the multi-columns setting, click Refresh to update the rack space in the Display panel. You can also change the number of partitions for the selected use space individually. To add devices to the rack, select the category and vendor name from the drop-down list in the Info panel to filter the device list. drag and drop the device to add it to the rack in the display panel. You can remove the device from the rack as well. Once finished, click Save. And the rack setting is complete. The floor map allows you to add and configure a new floor map. Go to the Setting drop-down menu, and select Floor Map. Click Add to add a new floor map. Name your map, and set the refresh time for data reload in the info panel. You can also set the share view, to decide who can see this floor map, and its data. Click Background to upload the floor plan. Click the Layout Size button to adjust the floor map size, and click Save. Drag and drop devices from the list to the floor map. Click Save, and move on to the map settings. The map settings allows you to manage the power capacity, PUE, environmental data, and facility utilization of the data center. In the floor map page, select the map that you would like to configure, then click Map Settings. Set the maximum power rating of the floor map. And then, set the range of the output power values for normal, warning and severe status. You can also change the default PUE, temperature, and humidity values, according to your needs. Enter the total area of the floor map. You can also change the minimum power consumption of an active rack. And the range of facility utilization values for normal, warning, and severe status if needed. Click Save, and the map settings is complete. The device group allows you to categorize your equipment into groups. In the floor map page, select the map that you would like to set up, and click on the device group button. You will see three default groups, and you can select devices from the right table, and add them to the selected groups in the left table. You can also create a new group, under the floor map, by clicking the Add button, and assign the device to the selected group. Click Save, and the device group setting is complete. The power calculation allows you to calculate the total power output and total energy consumption of the equipment within each device group. In the floor map page, select the map that you would like to set up and click on the power calculation button. Choose the equipment for power and energy calculation. So the system is able to calculate the power output and energy consumption of selected equipment, according to your settings. Click Save. Now, the setting is complete.